Hey Virgo, this is Kelly from House of Virgo. Hope you are all doing well. Welcome to my channel if you're new. Please do hit like, share, and subscribe if you enjoy my readings. This channel is for Virgos and Virgos only. Virgo Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus. So, as you know, some of the messages may or may not resonate. Just take what fits, leave the rest, and we're going to take a look at the energy of the person you may be connecting with. Past, the present energies, and the future. And if you'd like to get a personal reading from me, there's a link in the description box below this video where I do 30-minute or 1-hour phone calls. All right, so let's take a look here, Virgo. See what the love messages are going forward here. Okay, chemistry, strong magnetic attraction, okay, and new love, and that's in the past, okay? So I feel like your person, when you guys met, definitely chemistry, definitely a strong attraction between the two of you. You stirred this person's romantic feelings, okay? And you blew the top off of their ego as well. But your person stalemated or didn't make really any decisions about moving forward in the past due to this Eight of Swords energy, self-esteem issues, or feeling like they could not get out of a situation. There might have been a lot of low confidence, things like that with this person. Okay, let's take a look at this tower. So we do have Scorpio, Aquarius, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, Taurus. Okay, all right, so the tower energy, the moon. So you made this person really consider their emotions in the past. That's Piscean energy. Okay, I don't feel like anyone ever came close enough to make this person take a look at their emotions, the depth of their feelings, you know, to want to make voluntary changes in a relationship, you know. Yeah, here, Piscean energy again. So some of you may definitely be dealing with or had dealt with a Pisces, but, you know, that's what I was saying with this hanged man energy. This person was like, really was able to gain new perspective on love because of you and because the way that you made them feel. But why did they, so they, I felt like they kind of stalemated the relationship or blocked progression forward. Yeah, they wanted to very much. There was a turning point, but I feel like this person really had deep struggles with their like anxiety issues or self-esteem problems, or they felt stuck in a situation, or they weren't able to move things forward. They definitely viewed you as having this Empress energy, and that's Libran energy as well. And so they did communicate with you a lot in the past, or had a lot of ideas. This person was very smitten, or like kind of had a crush on you. They viewed you as someone who was like in that Empress energy, you know, just being like the queen, like she's the goddess energy for females, and for males just having like a complete abundance and just having a new beginning, and like no one compared to you in the past. But this person did not move the relationship forward because they didn't, either they didn't feel they were worthy or good enough for you, or that they could do or be what you needed them to be. I feel like that your person put you on a pedestal, and then they compared themselves to you and viewed you as being way too good for them. All right, so the present energy here. So passion and a heart-to-heart conversation is coming in, okay? The star energy here, this is renewal and having hope and faith. This person's still very hesitant, okay? But they want to talk to you. So I see some type of communication. That Page of Pentacles, it feels like they want to talk or discuss some plans, some solid things. But still up in the air, nothing definitive, nothing grounded, But it feels mostly like communicating with you. Maybe they may be talking to you about a new job or money that they've received or things like that. But I feel like there's also an energy here of wanting to get to the place where you guys can really talk about how you feel. Like, they do want to, but they're hesitant. But they're hopeful. So let's take a look at the star. Wow, the Lovers is here. This is a twin flame for sure. And this person, they're hopeful that you guys can come back together or to try to communicate or bring that love in or have that deep connection, that deep partnership here. That's Gemini energy. Why the hesitancy? Fear. Okay, still with this person. That's a devil energy. A lot of anxiety, fear. They're fearful of being deceived. They're fearful of deceiving themselves. They're fearful of letting you down, of not being... it just feels mostly like fear, okay? There might be some kind of an addictive quality about this person, that they're hesitant because they know that they can latch on to others, and especially you. There's a very strong passion, maybe sexual lust, that comes from this person. They're very passionate about you. Let's take a look at this Page of Pentacles, because I feel like this Page of Pentacles is more or less like treading water. I just heard treading water. Yeah, Eight of Swords again. They tread water. So they communicate with you in very like, how can I say this word? About mundane things or things that are not all that important. You know, like, in other words, like, it's just a way for them to connect with you. But still very, doesn't look like this person really got any healing, but it could also be, it could also have something, for some of you, it could have been that things were delayed in the past because of restrictions, and there are still restrictions in the present, but they still want to talk to you and have a heart-to-heart open conversation with you in the present. Either these are mental restrictions that are fear-based, or there are actual restrictions that are going on in the world at this time, okay? But there may be communication about, like, they have a gift, or they want to give you something, or there's, like, something tangible, right? This person truly does love you, though. I just want to pull a clarifying card for the Lovers. Look, here's the Tower. See? Your love still... brings them to their knees. They still have this sense about you where there's just nobody else that could have ever touched them the way you have, and they fear that. That love is so great. Yeah, and so restrictions and the Chariot. So there's a desire to come towards you and to take action and make change in the present in this relationship. This is Cancer energy. We also have Capricorn. There's a desire to do this, definitely, but there's a lot of fear and they're quite hesitant. And again, could be mental restrictions, self-imposed, self-sabotage, or it's actual restrictions going on in the world, or it's both. Now let's take a look at this future energy. Healing family issues, forgiving and learning. And I think I said I wasn't so sure if this person had healed, but guess what? Going forward, absolutely, healing. Okay, healing the family connection or relationship that you have go in the future, or healing their trauma from the past. Okay, so here we have the King of Wands, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. We have the World. So big shift and a big change, and the struggle coming to an end. Okay, and forgiving and learning. So I feel like your person, a lot of their struggle or their that Eight of Swords energy, that these restrictions in their mind or this fear base, is a lot to do with past stuff, because I feel like your person came into your relationship with that energy. I don't feel like it was anything that you did to cause them to be that way. I feel like they came in that way, and they've held back and not moved forward because of that, not being able to release and heal the past. but I see them doing this here. So let's take a look. The King of Wands comes across, okay, with justice, is being fair. The King of Wands is very influential and bold and is a go-getter. Okay, he takes action, he's very passionate, he's a bit feisty, but like has this self-assurance and confidence. So somewhere along the line, this heart-to-heart conversation that you guys have is going to induce healing with this person so that going forward, there's forgiveness and there's change. And then this person comes in desiring to do right by you or have a win-win solution between the two of you. And I think I said that's Libra energy. So that's Venus, that's balancing of the partnership. And this is also like karma too, in a lot of ways. I'm just picking this up. Like this person comes out with like a lot of truth about what they want. Look, the sun is here. So Leo energy and this change, moving into a very positive new beginning, a positive new start for the two of you. And that Ten of Wands, it's like, you know, I've been carrying around this. No, no, it's going to eat you up inside. It's like this person was carrying around a lot of struggles for themselves, you know, like a chip on their shoulder, you know, that is just exhausted and just has been like so stressed, a burden. This person has had a burden that they've been carrying around their whole life. And I feel like they want to get into a very positive place with you. There's self-love, unconditional love here. Yep, Six of Pentacles, that's reciprocity. This person could not give to you, or is realizes that in order to give to you, they have to drop what's already in their hands, right? So it's coming to terms with that, right? They could not be reciprocal or give you anything because they couldn't receive anything. They realize if their arms are closed and their hands are full, they can't receive and they really can't give. But see, look, I feel like they drop this here and then they're able to share and come in with more reciprocal energy of what it is that you want, and also the healing and the forgiving. I really feel like some type of conversation that you have with this person, or they have with you, or there's some truth and there's balance in this partnership, brings like a whole new change, right? And I feel like this person wanted a new change, and the Six of Pentacles is all about exchange and change. So yeah, it looks very positive going forward. A lot of healing and forgiving happening here. Let's take a look at this person's energy to see what was going on with them. A little more messages in regards to this person's energy. I wish things could be different. And they hope you're happy. They never want to feel without you or apart from you. They do wish you well. Taking time alone, there's a bit of a retreat here, and I feel like this is an energy. That's what they've done. They've retreated a lot, but then they kind of reach out or they come back, and then I feel like that's the end of it. That cycle is complete now. Your soulmate. So I did say twin flame for some of you, and for others, this is a soulmate. But this person loves, accepts, and respects you unconditionally. And you'll start feeling that energy from this person going forward in the near future. You came closer than anyone. See, that's what I said. I was picking up that energy right in the very beginning. And that's what I feel like. That's the truth. Okay. You touched something within them that vibrated throughout their heart and their body, and no one was ever able to do that with them. Or maybe nobody ever gave them a shot or a chance. You stuck, Virgo. You gave something to this person that's invaluable, and they're sorry. I feel like it's more so sorry for not being there when you needed them. Or not being able to come forward with you. And I kind of get a sense that this person is sorry for themselves as well, that they allowed themselves to not allow love to come in to their life, or just to be fearful about that. So many things remind you of them, or remind them of you, Virgo. And then a new love is blossoming here with you too. And for some, a recommitment to this love begins to develop going forward, which is so beautiful. Okay. And an external party was intruding on this relationship, interference. I feel like this was this their past. Okay. Something would be said or done, and this person's trauma would get triggered, and then it would just start this cycle all over again. Okay, addiction is affecting this relationship. So I felt like this person tends to get a little bit obsessed, and they have a fear that they're going to get addicted to this. Like they have to overcome these obsessions. There's a lot of codependency, I feel like, plays out on your person, comes out from them. Okay, yeah, I wish I had treated you better. So this person does feel like, yeah, they're sorry for that, for not treating you better in the past. If you guys decided at one point to remain friends, it starts leading to more. They want more, but you both have to be patient with each other. Everything will unfold in divine timing. Let me take a look at the charms. Okay. So, oh, we have a deer with antlers. Wow. Wait, aren't we in like the buck full moon or something right now? I think that's what it's called. The buck full moon should bring changes, or the residual left over from that. You'll start to see changes. Or maybe this person called you deer. This might even be a moose. I think it's a moose. Maybe somebody lives in like areas where they have mooses. I don't know what you call them, where they have those types of animals, like a moose somewhere, or somebody drinks moose beer, or there's like, like there's a moose head hanging on somebody's wall, or there's a nickname, Moose. And we also have a guitar here, okay? So somebody definitely is a guitar player or plays the guitar or is in a band or any kind of string instrument. Okay, now we have a teapot with tea. So there may be like a sit down, have tea together, or somebody likes tea. And I'm also seeing the teapot from Beauty and the Beast, the movie, the cartoon Disney thing. I forget what that was called, but there was, I don't know, Beauty and the Beast seems to be, it's like a conversation between Beauty and the Beast, you know? And then, oh, we have a Dachshund dog. Little dog. Somebody might have one of these little doggies. Dachshund dogs are very loyal, and I'm just seeing distance here. And also somebody makes these little pet clothing, pet shirts or something, like for pets. So there's a white shirt with a heart. I just feel like it kind of goes with this. For some of you, it goes with this doggy. There's like a doggy that wears like a little sweater or doggy clothes. Either somebody makes them or buys them or has an animal that has like a doggy clothing on it or something. I just want to get one more. Oh, okay. Now we've got palm trees. So palm trees are significant. Somebody lives in an area where there's palm trees. There's going somewhere where there's palm trees. All right. And then a spoon. Okay, you might be using a spoon right now or looking at a spoon. And these messages just basically are stating if these readings are for you or if they resonate. It just gives you more clarity if this reading is meant for you. The spoon, I'm not... A spoonful of sugar, I just heard. Like a spoonful of sugar. I don't know if anybody would give a spoon to somebody, but either you're mixing something with a spoon right now, or you're cleaning out your dishes or washing a spoon, or somebody has like a spoon, decorative spoon hanging on their kitchen wall, or no, or there's, it's attached to you somehow or some way, or doing something with a spoon. Very interesting. All right, Virgo, that's your reading. I hope that you enjoyed that. I will see you guys tomorrow. Have a great Monday. All right, take care. Bye.